Guys, it is Saturday, October 10th, 10/10/20. I knew that. With that being said, obviously very late because it's 5 p.m. But I'm supposed to condition, throw, and lift. But I think for my conditioning, sprint work, not gonna do anything crazy. I might do a set of hills. So instead of like pyramiding down 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I might just do, like a 3x2, 3x3, or maybe a 2x3. 2x2, I don't know, some format at some percentage rate to see how I feel. But I'm gonna open up with some 20-yard sprints, do a few reps of those. Debating if I want to throw. I might do some walkthroughs. I think what I'll, because I have to train with Steve tomorrow. So I think what I'll do is that I will do my warm-up, walk through that session, and then after that, I will wait to throw tomorrow because I don't want to burn myself out and then sprint, head to the gym. I got to do my Friday workout because I missed that. So I got to clip half of the Friday workout, do it today with my Saturday workout lifting session, excuse me, and then do the same for Sunday. Take the back half of Friday and then clip it to my Sunday workout. So it's going to be fun. See you guys in a bit. Also, yes, I know the focus was off on that, but I'm too lazy to re-record and say that because time is of the essence. It's getting dark. So deal with the out of focus. Gene, if you want to come through with your DaVinci and fix it for me, Isaiah, Hamza, someone want to come and fix that focus, holla at your boy, but I'm not going to do it. So, I'm here. When I say I'm here, what the fuck does that mean? But, 5:30. I don't know what I'm going to do. I feel like I'm going to skip. It sucks. I say I'm going to skip my. I say I'm going to skip my warm-ups for like kind of walking through my drills, but I feel like I have to throw today because I didn't throw on Friday. So I might just literally do, I'll do my dynamic warm-up. I'll do 5 reps of all of my drills. Just get like a solid 10 throws in and see where I land. And I just remember that I forgot my tripod. But I'm gonna put all this down, get like a little warm-up in, and then run to my car. That'll be the warm-up. And then conditioning-wise, it's probably not gonna be a big day. Probably just be some hill runs. Unfortunately, I'm too tired. So that is Jackson? I'm at the Fabled Circle. So oh, I'm not in frame. Gene, I'm not in frame. Sorry about that. And I don't have the road mic on. So let's hope everything gets picked up. But all that noise aside, is like I said when I was coming in earlier, just because of time constraints, because I still want to lift and do my sprints. I'm just gonna go ahead and knock out some warm-ups, some drills, start throwing. I'll probably get 5 throws in on camera just to get them, and then I'll get a real good 5 or 10 throws. So I'm gonna get two. Let me just set this up properly. Before I throw, I'll warm up with the football a little bit, but right now. See, that's when you're just turning and not going left, right? We're going left. We're not just turning, we're also going to be going left, right? Better. That was a lot better.
see, on that, down to the balls of your feet, right? Kind of coming over versus a smooth, flat area.
That was the one.
That was the one, buddy.
Let's do one more and then start throwing. So I want to get some of the early throws out and then start throwing him. That's a very short version of a Sajin Doshi practice, but I want to get my sprints in. I want to still lift. So this will end by 6:30. It's 6:07, so Tristan throws him now. Thank you. so slow and controlled that you're literally hanging out here. I'm just kind of like waiting. Like, all right, do I go? Part of me is like debating. Yeah, but I'm not. Let me get two of one. This is one, right? Before I start watching it in slow. Because if you want to not waste the S&Qs, you know? All right, I'm gonna end it here and get some slow motions in.
Oh, after watching some of those throws in slow motion, you know, the one thing that's very clear to me off the bat is the power. The power is just still not there in my legs. And you can tell when you look at my slow motion throws, especially from the back to circle, look at the trajectory, right? You want it to be a parabola. It's almost like my discus wants to go up, but it's just not. You know, that power is not there. I see it going, and it just kind of flatlines and falls. From a technique perspective, though, you know, I know I'm choppy, you know, maybe even uneven at the back of the circle. I'm not concerned about that for someone like me who's been throwing for 15 years. Like, yes, that's on the to-do list. Like, don't forget about it. But that's more of a rhythm, timing. As I start throwing more and more at full speed, I'll be more settled and calm and not jumpy at the end, right? Jumpy like our car shot in the courtesy. Shout out to you know who. With that being said, hey, anyway, jokes aside, you know, there are things technically that I want to improve, but I was really happy with that. I mean, there's nothing more that I can ask than to throw down the middle. Yes, you know, I'm not that wide coming out the back. I'll try to get some throws in from the front, like camera-wise, to see what that looks like, my right leg coming around, driving to the middle. Maybe my left arm isn't as straight as I thought it's been, but it's getting a lot better. But the one thing you can tell is a year off, what that does is that pop is not there. But I feel like, because I know where that 50, 55 meter mark range is, which is kind of what my PR is. Those are around 160s, but what's 160 to 200, right? Or even a 180, what was close to my PR. So yeah, pop is not there, but I can't be mad, right? I'm really happy with how that looks. But again, pop wasn't there. I'm gonna get in 5 more throws and call it a day. Again, that strict throw count too, right? Like 10 throws and that's it. So let me get in 5 throws and that'll be that. And then we'll start doing some of these sprints and then head to the gym. And then Pavan, I gotta lie and say that I'm running late so I could lift a little bit longer.
I need a girl from Kentucky. Hey, Elena, what's good? I need a girl who's gonna love me. I need a girl who's gonna trust me. Someone to fuck. Someone to make me feel love. Someone that's so proud to be with me. She walk right up to her ass, look her dead in the face and say, you ain't got to.
You're really like coming up with that and you want to do so much.
they're like so excited to do so many things, and because I know what I can do coming up. I know how lethal I am. I know how good I can be. All right, I know how good I can be. It's not strong enough. See how it looks from the front.
More time with family and friends, more life. More time to get it right. I'm actually going to turn it off and do some S&Q. Look at my history. I'm trying to see what's different from that guy and the rich of me. The only thing I see is custom miles from Tiffany and some gunners that'll hit you out of nowhere like Epiphany. Really, that's it to me. Aside from the obvious, man, the changes in scenery. Testing me, gon' have my niggas testing machinery. They say that they happy, my man, that's not how they seem to be. The boy, he wild and peaceful, rest in peace, Tina Marie. Ethics and values, mob traditions, old-fashioned, monopoly action. Ronnie buying up Brentwood like he's still in Akron. A lot of pain, a lot of passion, a lot of relaxing while other niggas is overreacting. That's how we continue down the path of Jordan and Jackson. Fuck, clearly, I'm not happy. And the reason that is... Aubrey, I'm gonna need you to calm down a little bit right now. The reason I'm not too happy is because I know where I could be. The strength, even if my technique was a little bit back to what it was, I'm choppy out the back like a motherfucker. Maybe I try not to like wind up too much because it's all this weight transfer fucking shit that's going on, but it's really hard for me to leave the field like this. But I gotta know when to stop. Don't overthrow, you know, stay alive to come back another day. But fuck. I'm pissed about some of those throws because they could have been fucking monsters.